Hello, everyone. Good morning. This is a daily reading. This is your weekly jobs outlook report, career report reading, tarot reading for the collective as requested by one of the viewers. So let's see what we have for this week. The overall energy for the collective. Let's see what we have, spirit. Let's cut the deck and see. Career. Every career is super important. All right. Ace of Pentacles, a new job, a new opportunity, somebody making an offer, something that has been growing for a while, something that you deserve, but it's new money, nice energy, perfect energy for a collective career reading. And we are in the time of Capricorn, which is all about career. We have in the recent past, Ten of Wands. Many of you have had to give up something that's been very challenging. It's letting go of the burdens. It's letting go of the burden of maybe a job that you have right now that's recent past. The current energy is a Ten of Swords. So it looks as though many of you were treated unfairly or have been treated very unfairly. Ten of Swords is like, you know, Ten of Wands, Ten of Swords. Something is done, over. It's good riddance. Be glad it's gone. We're going to look and see how your employer is viewing the situation with you. They're in a crisis. Your company is in a meltdown crisis. They have a shortage of supplies. There's no foundation in their business at this time because they've had so many losses. So let's look and see how they view you. They view you. Look at this. It's a Nine of Wands. Somebody who is fiery. Somebody who has a great deal of passion. Somebody who's very skilled at what they do. We get to the nines. You're at the top of your game. They see you as someone who would really be a perfect fit for them because you have fire in your belly. You're willing to work hard. How they feel about you. The Sun card. Nice. The Sun card is that chemistry, that connection, you know, that you are projecting that proper image of being fun to work with, somebody who comes to work with a good disposition. You look at things from a higher perspective. They see you as a great match to fill a very big a position in their corporation or their, you know, whoever it is that you're going to be working for. It's something that's very foundational for them. They need your skill set, hard work, a good attitude, a willingness to work for a fair rate. We have Ten of Cups. Okay, you're chosen. You're getting the job. Ten of Cups tells me that they have every intention of hiring you. You have three tens here. Talk about a new beginning. We have also, look at this, Empress energy. They feel as though you are a catch, that you are the Empress. So you're coming in, you're attracting this. You don't really have to prove yourself here. You just have to stand in your power, be who you are, you know, lay out on the table, you know, your skill set. They really are also frantic that they may not be able to have you. So spirit is recommending that you hold back, you know, that you let them come to you. Also too, spirit is saying that you can set yourself free if you want to. But the Eight of Swords is self-imposed restriction. So spirit is saying don't get too worked up about this. We'll see why when we clarify. Okay. King of Swords energy, I love it. Samurai energy, perfect for selecting a good job. It's looking at things again, higher perspective. You see this from the position of the Sun, from your position of strength. Your person, they are looking at you as a warrior, somebody who will go the distance, somebody who brings everything to the table. You look good. You like an amazing, amazing opportunity for them. So when you're in that Empress energy, you have to know that you have a lot of power. So let's go ahead and clarify this. I love this reading for you guys. Welcome to the channel if you're new, and thanks for watching if you're a regular subscriber. This also can apply to any question that you have. Realistically, you can always reframe a question. But right now we're looking at work, work, work. Page of Pentacles, what does it mean? Judgment card, decision has been made to make an offer to you. It will be shortly if it hasn't been already. Ten of Wands, what was the burden you gave up? Trying to get a fair shake from an older employer, somebody who has been really difficult for you. Why the Ten of Swords? The truth is you don't want to be there. Many of you were in an environment that was very maybe backstabbing, that was very cliquish, that had people that had their own agendas. You weren't treated fairly. It was too much of a burden. Why the Tower card? Yeah, devil energy. Okay. So what we're looking at here, I mistakenly took this. Well, I think it's both. I feel as though that the person who's looking at you really needs you. They need you so much that you have the upper hand. So they're going to try to come across like, oh, we can't afford that. Or they have some really strong restrictions here that could be toxic. So let's look at that energy. Let's look and see what that means. Okay, but the Fool card, you're getting an offer. The offer may not come in as to be as high as you want. Spirit is saying if it doesn't, think about this logically and hold yourself back. Four of Swords, they're hurting. They're really hurting. This is like an airplane that can't take off. Okay, King of Wands. So it really behooves you. They're going to come across with this really, you know, very kind of almost a cocky attitude with you. They're going to come across like they have it all together, and I don't think they do. They really don't. They seem to be having a major crisis. And, you know, we're getting that a lot of people left, that you have the knowledge that they need, that you have the authority, the ability to be who you want to be, that they've had a very difficult time with their traditional sort of rigidity, I would say. And it looks like they're really tired of not being able to get the hires. This company or entity has gone through a really big downturn, and I think very much COVID related, but that's not really, you know, your issue. So let's see here. So it doesn't look like they're going to walk away from you. They're not going to terminate it if you know, need more money. Let's see what the answer to this Eight of Swords is. Ten of Cups, you're going to be happy if you hold back. That's going to get you to your happily ever after. Ten of Cups, Ten of Cups. Just holding back, you know, giving it some thought. And I would even say that your response is when they come back and they say, we don't want to give you what you want. You know, this is what we have to offer. This is what we require. The best response is to say, let me think about it. Five of Swords, you can play a little bit of a mind game with them. Say, you know, I'd like a few days to think about it. Can I get back with you next week? And we see that they're going to take that as a Ten of Swords moment, at which point they seem to increase the offer, okay? So that Six of Cups, as they come back to you again, they sweeten the offer and they come back. The King of Swords, tell us about this King of Swords. Ace of Cups, a new lovely job. All right, I'm going to wrap it up there. Hey, Collective, sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from.